Certainly have. We're going to start off with a bang because the German Kurt Von Hess in there against everybody's favorite Rufus R. Freight Train Jones.
That's
and
right.
We got a lot of other action. Tully Blanchard and Wahoo McDaniels together as a tag team. However, they're up against a pretty team and pretty strong team themselves. And Ryan Adidas and Pistol Pez Wadley, who we've seen recently get better and better every week goes along. We don't want to ever leave out Wadley and Adidas. And I think before that match is over, that the fans and Wahoo and Tully will remember Adidas and Wadley for a long time.
That is correct. Plus, Nikita Koloff is here. Also, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vant, and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. We have several special announcements. One is from the World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. So this is the exciting hour of the best in professional wrestling.
NWA style, the Major League of Professional Wrestling. Paul Number One Jones and the Assassin will be around.
Yes. All right, there, in the ropes. Hess has that hair pulling at it. Takes Rufus. Rufus switches. Catches him.
Well, Kurt Von Hess is no upstart wrestler. He's been around a long time, and he should give Rufus a tough match here.
All right, Rufus has that beard.
The king of professional wrestling.
I know that hurts.
Yeah, you would. You would, David.
Rufus has that arm, twisting at it.
King of professional wrestling, Rufus R. Freight Train Jones. When he gets that freight train wound up, the crowd really gets electrified and it usually puts that opponent out.
And right after this match, I have an interview with the American Dream, the one and only Dusty Rhodes.
Live and on the scene. And boy, if you haven't seen him, you gather everybody around that TV set because he electrifies people when he walks into any room or coliseum.
Rufus now still has that arm. Yes, pounding away. Goes in the ropes.
You know, we've had the Assassin 1 and 2 and Paul Jones, and they've had a lot of run-ins with people. Rufus has been involved, and they're right in the middle of that. He's not going to take a back seat to none of them, and he's not with Kurt Von Hess.
All right, Rufus now takes Hess, whips him across into the ropes. Here comes the freight train, Joe. He's got it rolling.
He's got it wound up. Another freight train. Hess stays by the two freight trains. Hard hit, but down goes Hess. And we got a victor. Rufus R. Freight Train Jones. A great win for Rufus. Over Kurt Von Hess, a rugged veteran. Here we're going to see it again. Hess off the ropes. And Rufus winds up the freight train. From there was a headbutt, and the winner, Rufus R. Freight Train Jones.
All right, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty, what about Tully Blanchard?
Well, let's just lay it right on the line now. We're talking about my unity tour, and we're talking about my taking care of business tour. I made it very plain, David Crockett. 60 minutes, TV title, anywhere in the building, anywhere in the States, anywhere in the world. My unity tour brings us all together. And we're going to get all the gold and all the silver. Wahoo McDaniel, the one-eyed Jack, United States heavyweight title, I want that. I'm waiting to see what happens. Bear Windham signs for Big Fancy Car and everything. I make $500,000 plus a year, Daddy. There's nobody or nothing I can't drive or have. Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, has made it personally understood that the Mid-Atlantic, the worldwide wrestling area, is now his home base. You're looking at 2 times World Heavyweight Champion. You're looking at 7 times Florida Heavyweight Champion. You're looking at co-holders at one time of the world, Tag Team Champion. You're looking at the greatest sports attraction in this world today, and we're going to start taking care of business. and taking care of business is what it's all about. My Unity Tour 84, David, it's going to be electrified, funk personified, because Dusty Rhodes going to call for Unity. We're going to get Unity, because Unity's out there for us. Now, let me tell you something, Tully Blanchard. One more time, in case you got cotton in your ear. 60 Minutes, TV Town. Bring it on home to me, baby.
All right, we'll be back with more right after this.
Students across the country are banding together to do something about America's number one teenage killer, driving drunk.
This is a contract signed between you and your parents, and it can save your life.
What this is saying is that I agree to give you a call if I ever find myself in a dangerous situation, like having had too much to drink or being with someone who really shouldn't be driving.
And if I call, you agree to come pick me up, no questions asked, until we can talk about it later.
And you also agree to find a safe room if you've had too much to drink.
Students Against Driving Drunk want you to know that alcohol-related accidents are the number one cause of teenage death in America.
It's important because with this, you have a choice.
It's an agreement that protects the both of us.
So next time I'm late, you won't have to worry.
And the next time you're late, I won't have to worry about you.
Make the agreement that can save lives.
To find out how you can help, write to SAD. Corbin Plaza, Marlboro, Mass. 01752.
This Sunday on the Alfred Hitchcock Hour.
Oh, Molly. Molly. Oh, I'm sorry, Molly. I'm sorry. I thought you were...
The Alfred Hitchcock Hour, Sunday nights at 11:30, here on TV6.
The shortest distance between you and an understanding of the news is a straight line of information. Direct, clear, reliable. Put together by an organization of seasoned journalists and presented by the nation's leading anchorman. As managing editor, Dan Rather knows how to report a story in the clearest possible way. That's why now, more than ever, the CBS Evening News with Dan Rather is the leading evening news broadcast in America.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you see him right there. Mark Youngblood, one of the young lions, one of a team of true lions. The renegade Mark Youngblood against Doug Vines. They have a purpose, John. They're going to wrestle with a purpose.
They're hot on the trail. That World Tag Team Championship held by Kernoodle and Koloff. And Mark Youngblood, exciting athlete in that ring. And he'll keep the pace pretty fast here for Doug Swords. Strong words out of the mouth of American Dream.
Oh, yes.
He's got that Unity Tour in high gear, it seems like. A lot of heads are going to roll, I'm afraid.
Yeah. But he wants, what he wants right now is Tully Blanchard and a 60-minute time limit.
All right, Mark Youngblood steps in, locks that arm bar. Takes Vines over down to the mat. The renegade Mark Youngblood together just hold an unsurpassable man.
Right now. There you see some. Hey, John, these fans, this is what makes us the best. Hey, you see the renegade too out there watching his brother in this match. And all right, they're wrestling. Yeah, they've been wrestling tag so long, ever since he came in. Now, they're testing themselves. Really, they're testing themselves as a single. Because as you well know, it's really hard to wrestle in a single match.
Well, it sharpens up their timing. It sharpens up their quick moves. And, of course, when they know they have to go in time and time again after that World Tag Team belt. What a battle it is.
Casey whips him across into the turnbuckle. Takes his time coming across.
Fine move. We could have a win right here. Rolls him up. No, just a two count. Vines escapes. Mark right back on the attack, David.
has that arm. Boy, did he chop him.
That rang out all over our packed auditorium here, NWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling. And the best right there is two of them, the Renegade and Mark Youngblood. Down another lateral press. Just a one count this time. You're not going to put Doug Vines away that easy.
All right, slam down that. Tries for the pin again. That's right. He needs to tie his legs up.
He goes right back after that arm, though. He's wearing him down. Pick that arm to have his attack on. Referee Tommy Young finding NWA official right on top of the action.
Right, Vine, short punches into the midsection. Right, breaks him right across the eyes.
Ooh, that stops the ball. Ooh, face full of turnbuckle for Mark Youngblood. And the crowd starts that staccato chant behind Mark.
Mark blocks it. Nice chop. Takes him, whips him across now. Good drop kick. Gets his right,
right on the button.
Jaw. Another drop kick. Let's see what he does now. Picks him up. Across. Double jump. Comes in, grabs
him. That leg this time, David.
Pin.
We could have a win.
Yes,
we
go.
Mark Youngblood. Exciting match for the young Indian and the winner, Mark Youngblood. Over Doug Vines. Here you see Mark connect with a beautiful executed drop kick, and he goes on to take the victory. The winner, Mark Youngblood.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area. Hampton Roads Coliseum, a big card Friday, August 24th at 8:15. You'll want to be on hand for that one. And the Stafford Senior High School Gym in Fredericksburg, Virginia, big card on Thursday, August 23rd, the time 8:15. But now let's talk about the Richmond Coliseum on Friday, August 17th at 8:15, a big card. You'll see Don Cornettle and Ivan Koloff, the world's tag team champions, go up against the Renegade and Brian Adidas. The assassin number one, Paul Jones, takes on Rufus Sire Freight Train Jones. You'll see for the TV title, $10,000, a 20-minute time limit, and a pinfall will count anywhere in the building. Tully Blanchard defends against Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vine. And then, fans, listen to this. For the world's heavyweight title, Nature Boy Ric Flair defends the world's belt against Chief Wahoo McDaniel. Let's bring in the world's tag team champions. They will go up against Brian Adidas and the Renegade.
You know, Ivan, I always knew the Indians was gutless. But when you can't get your own brother to be your partner, that's something else. But you know, the whipping we gave him last time in Richmond, I don't blame him. I wouldn't be there either. What do you think about
that? That's right, Brian. Not only the best of America, the best of Russia, but the best in the whole world. Now, this Renegade goes out and gets a new partner, this Adidas. It's going to be happy hunting ground for you, Renegade. And this Adidas, he's just like an old pair of running shoes. We're going to walk all over him.
The assassin number one will take on Rufus R. Freight Train Jones.
You know, Richmond Coliseum is a big place for Rufus R. Jones. The people stand behind him. But let me tell you something, Rufus. When the assassin number one gets his hands on you, it's going to be an awful embarrassing place for you.
You know, Rufus R. Jones, I understand that you're hungry for fame and glory. Well, I'm not going to appease your appetite, but I'm going to feed you. And this is exactly what I'm going to feed you, right in your big mouth.
Pinfalls will count anywhere in the building. It's for the TV title, a 20-minute limit, and $10,000. You'll take on Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant.
You know, Jimmy Valiant, Richmond Coliseum, two shows ago, you had your chance, your night in glory, your chance for the money and the TV championship. And you came just a little bit short, a little bit this much short of manhood. Just like I said you would, Jimmy Valiant. And you know, then when I get done with Jimmy Valiant, pin falls anywhere in the building, I'm going to sit back. I may even sit on the front row, Ric Flair, and I'm going to watch the Super Chief, Wahoo McDaniels, win the World's Heavyweight Championship. Richmond Coliseum. You know, it's never seen a World's Heavyweight Championship change hands, but it's going to on Friday night because, you know, Ric Flair, you're an endangered species. And Wahoo McDaniels is a hunter.
Mike Wise, an involved VCU educator, cares about his community. As a United Way board member, he feels good about being part of the volunteer team which decides how contributions raised can best be utilized right here at home. Call today and find out how you can volunteer through the United Way of Greater Richmond.
It's the season when lovers everywhere are turning their thoughts to romance.
We even held hands as we walked along the sludge and the mud of the river.
The joy.
It just gets me all excited.
Oh, the rapture.
Yeah, I was just out of my skin about it.
As Love Connection brings singles together.
It was definitely a physical attraction.
Spring fever's highly contagious.
Here comes the romantic part.
Every day on Love Connection.
Love Connection, weekdays at 5 on TV6.
All right, fans, and with us right here ringside, a pleasure to welcome and introduce to you David Crockett. And David, I understand you've got some good news for all our wrestling.
That we do. And it's a pleasure on behalf of Jim Crockett Promotions. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, I want to go to my brother, Jim Crockett, for a very special announcement, because it is something.
We at Jim Crockett Promotions and the National Wrestling Alliance have always prided ourselves on bringing our fans the very best in professional wrestlers. It is my privilege to announce today that we have signed Barry Windham to the most lucrative contract ever signed by a professional athlete. And on behalf of Jim Crockett Promotions, we would like to present you these keys to a custom Z28 convertible.
Well, thank you. That's something I wasn't expecting, but I would like to say something. You know, now that I've signed with Jim Crockett Promotions, I intend to do my very best in the future, and I'm very happy to wrestle under the Crockett banner. And something that I'm looking forward to, Mr. Crockett, is the Starcades 84. I'm looking forward to the big match there and signing for something there.
I would also like to announce that Mr. Barry Windham will have his first match for Jim Crockett Promotions on August the 18th in Greensboro, North Carolina. His opponent will be the current Canadian heavyweight champion, one half of the World Tag Team Champions, and that is the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff.
That's right. That's going to be a hard one.
Thank you very much, Mr. Windham.
Thank you very much, sir.
David, that's exciting news right there.
It is exciting. And you know, he's a big guy.
He is big.
And speaking of Barry Windham, the man, we have him wrestling Harley Race on television. It's where he defeated Race when he was the World Heavyweight Champion. We roll that tape. We want to show you people how tough and determined this young man, Barry Windham, is.
All right, and David, you pointed out that Race was the heavyweight champion at this time, right?
Yes, he is. And he's pounding away. This match has been going on, a very grueling match. Now, watch this young man.
He's got Race. He just held him by the head, and he really sent him flying with that right hand right onto the face.
And look at Race. Harley Race, the man that has always been on the offensive, that has always had control. He doesn't have control in this match. Barry Windham has the control. He is the man right now.
And it looks like you're right, David. When you look at him and look at him in the ring, you can see that the champion right now is reeling and staggering around, and it looks like Windham is the one that right now still has the most of it.
He just missed that, Larry. He wanted to catch Harley Race. He would have taken his head off right then. All right, Harley Race, this is Harley Race's opportunity. And he needs everything he can against Barry Windham.
Set him up for the suplex. Right. Windham went right behind
him. That's right. That shows you how intelligent this young man is. He got him down. Got him for that pin.
And he pinned him.
That's it. That's what it is. Barry Windham, one of the greatest wrestling talents in the world today. And we do it because we have the greatest wrestling fans in the world. They are something else. And you deserve the best, and we're going to bring you the best.
All right, David. And talking about the best, we got one of those matches in the ring right now. Let's go to the ring.
There you see him. You might not like him, but that man right there, assassin number one, Paul Jones, they're the best. They're some of the best. They've got a young man in there right now, Sam Houston. He's a good one, too. He's one of these young, up-and-coming wrestlers. You can see an upset.
And the assassin, as you indicated, David, he is one of the best. He's never had that mask taken off.
That's correct.
However, sometimes in wrestling, animosities happen, egos get stepped on, insults are thrown, feuds happen, and then feuds come to a boiling point. And they cut Jimmy Valiant's beard, then one of those masks came off, assassin number two.
That's right.
Now we see assassin number one has got his hand taped up. We heard from the Jones camp the insults or the challenges that came out last week. And now I understand that Jimmy Valiant is quick to pick up that challenge.
That's right. He has picked it up. All right. Catch it. Goes down.
Five move by Sam Houston.
this one.
All right, you were talking about upsets. This young man, he wants to do it.
Almost had one there.
That's right. All right, you see the tape fist.
Startled him.
All right, you see the tape fist. Assassin number one, he wants to take Jimmy Vann into a match, a tape fist match. Anything goes in those matches, John, as you well know. Vann, he's accepted.
And it's been clearly stated by the Assassin and Paul Jones that Assassin has never lost one of these matches. I've been close to Jimmy Valiant for a long time. I don't really know if he ever had one, but I know he accepted the challenge, and we all of us know that Jimmy Valiant can
fight. Good top kick by the Assassin. Knocks Houston down on the mat, rolls him over, goes for that pin.
There's no bigger brawler than Jimmy Boogie Woogie Man Valiant. That dude will come to a boiling point.
That's right, it will. All right. Assassin and Vann, something has got to get. Coming out of that tape fist match, one of them will come out of it. You know that, John. One of those men will come out of that match. All right, goes for the pin again. There, he's just taking his time trying to pin Houston, trying to make the young man suffer.
But he has
Houston,
the control
back,
we talk
fighting.
About so many times. He has the control of the match right now.
He likes to inflict punishment, and that's what he's doing
right
now.
I know this is setting well at this particular moment in the match with number one Paul Jones, as the Assassin has everything just about his way right now. There's Paul Jones on the outside.
Coming up, you know, you see the Assassin coming up later in the program. The Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vann. Nice shoulder by the Assassin. Catches Houston again, almost knocks him through the ropes.
Him right through that second and third rope, almost out of the ballpark. Houston almost out of the ballpark again. Referee Tommy Young trying to hold him in there.
It's a legal blow, though, Johnny. We might not like it, but it's a legal blow. Knocking the wind out of Houston, this young man.
He's slowly and methodically cutting up Houston right now as the Assassin number one has the upper hand.
The Assassin's a pro. He's a definite pro.
That's why he's kept that. That's exactly why he's kept that mask so long. There's Paul Jones, a fine shot of him. He's got a little change of heart, but doesn't look too worried right here. Yeah, he agrees with that move by Assassin number one.
Assassin drops a big elbow.
I've never seen the Assassin so methodical. You think he's getting primed?
He's got to. He's got to be.
Primed.
He's got control.
That hand tape.
Yeah, he's think. How can he control Jimmy Vann? Vann is such a ball of fire. Always
and
moving. Listen to
the
fans.
There's unity for you. All of our fans in this jam-packed auditorium holler, we want Jimmy Vann. Did he catch him coming off right on the button? Hooks the leg. I don't even believe that was necessary in that case. He really caught him.
And he enjoyed it, too. And you see, look at the smirk on Paul Jones' face.
He enjoyed it also.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with more right after this.
This is WTVR TV6 Community Calendar. A Richmond Area Association for Retarded Citizens family picnic will be held on Saturday, August 18th from 2 p.m. until dark at Camp Baker, 7600 Beach Road in Chesterfield County. Bring swimsuits and plan for a good time. Call 748-4789 for reservations. If you ride a motorcycle, come join the fight against the crippling disease of arthritis at the 3rd Annual Arthritis Charity Poker Run. Come to Honda World, 6221 Hull Street Road at 10 a.m. on Sunday, August 19th. Call 282-5491 today for details. And the George Wythe High School Class of 1964 is planning a 20-year class reunion, and they're trying to locate all 279 members of the senior class. If you have any information, please call 790-1117 after 6 p.m. Please send all information at least 3 weeks in advance to WTVR TV6 Community Calendar, 3301 West Broad Street, Richmond, Virginia.
There's no better way to shape up your summer than with a TV6 pack of prizes. This month's winner will enjoy a 25-inch Zenith TV console from Vilme TV and Appliance. Assorted fine artist supplies from the Art Market. This Pennsylvania house, solid cherry miniature bachelor's chest from Virginia Wayside Furniture. A front-end alignment and five steel-belted radios, balanced and mounted from Peloton Ford Mercury. A free one-year membership for you and a friend to Mademoiselle Spa. The amazing T20 trimmer from Shindawa. And $600 worth of free groceries from Farm Fresh. It's a TV six-pack of values guaranteed to make your summer sizzle. Pick up your entry form today from the Art Market, Virginia Wayside Furniture, Cliffs Honda Yamaha, the Software Center, Farm Fresh, Holiday House, M. Camborian Sons, Domino's Pizza, Pleasure Craft Tours, Powhatan Ford Mercury, Mademoiselle Spa, and Vilme TV and Appliance. Register today to win a sizzling TV six-pack of fabulous prizes.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Here it is. And there's the man that's after it, among a lot of things. We know you are a change, Wahoo. There's no question about that. You want the United States Heavyweight Championship, but you can't have it.
Well, let me tell you something. As far as I'm concerned, the U.S. Heavyweight Championship is my belt until Ricky Steamboat wins it back. The NWA, and you say NWA, I say NWA Crockett Promotions. It's all one thing. Because they made a ruling on this belt. Never before has the NWA ever made a ruling on a major belt. Why all of a sudden they pick on this? I'll tell you one thing. If Steamboat had won that belt and I'd have been hit by the chair, I'm going to tell you people out there right now, Steamboat would have the belt. It wouldn't have been held up, and you can't make me believe it yet. It was.
All right, wait a minute. Don't leave. We want to talk about Ric Flair now. Now that you're such a changed man, the world heavyweight champion Ric Flair, what are you trying to do to him, you and Tully?
Well, you know, the man stuck his nose in my business. Here I did. I took a lot of time out of my career to help Ric Flair to get where he is. What did he do when he became the world's champion? He switched. Never gave me a title. Switched on me. Sure, as long as I drove him around, he was happy. Well, that's fine, Flair, because you're going to have to drive your own self. And you're going to find out when that belt's not around your waist, you're not going to have as many friends as you had. And I'm going to tell you another thing. I've got a film, and I'm going to show it to the people, too, where I beat you right in the middle of the ring, 1, 2, 3. You never tells people that. But I'm telling you, Flair, I'm not afraid of him. He knows that I can beat him because I've beaten him more times than any man in wrestling today. I've beaten Ric Flair. He knows that. I hold more wins over him. Sure, he didn't want to come back to the Mid-Atlantic area and wrestle. I guess not, because it's the toughest area in the world. And Steamboat, I'll tell you one thing. I'm not worried about the U.S. belt because I'll get it back. I beat you once. I can beat you again, and I'm going to beat Flair, too.
Year, the Foundation for Exceptional Children's Yes, I Can program honors hundreds of disabled young people for their personal triumphs, large or small, with a certificate of achievement. These are a few of the letters inspired by the determination that makes these children truly exceptional. Karen has missed many weeks of school due to Crohn's disease. Still, she has organized her community to raise funds for this disease, which has no cure. Chris is dyslexic, but he's now reading on grade level. Kathy was born with spina bifida and has had surgery 9 times with more to come. Still, she participates in neighborhood sports and faces each game with a yes, I can attitude. There are so many exceptional young people who can and do achieve. If you know one, please write us so that we can encourage everyone to say,
yes, I can.
Write Foundation for Exceptional Children, Reston, Virginia.
Weekdays at 5:30, the afternoon fun rolls on at TV6 with Alice. It's good family entertainment as Alice pulls the gang out of one fix after another. Come on down to Mel Steiner for a side-splitting order of laughter on Alice. 5:30 weekdays on WTVR TV6.
We've got the touch.
We've got it.
Here on TV6.
Every weekday morning, you have another chance to beat the dragon with Tic-Tac-Toe, America's favorite money game show where contestants match wits to outfox the dragon, winning big cash and prizes.
I just really do. I'm going to think positive for you.
You need $300 or Tic. She takes three. For $300, she got it!
Join host Wink Martindale for the cash, fun, and excitement of Tic-Tac-Toe every weekday morning at 9:30, right here on TV6.
And there you see the one and only Boogie Woogie Man for New York City. As he makes his way to the ring, you think that guy's not popular? Look at our fans.
They love him.
Look at our fans out there.
The boogeyman, Jimmy. Look at him running over just to touch him. You think he was the president?
As far as I'm concerned, Wahoo McDaniel's really a changed person. Hey. David, you know the thing, he's a great athlete, he's a great football player, one of the greatest wrestlers there ever was. Now he's changed, but he's turned his back on the fans.
Yes, he has.
And if fans boo him, of course, he just walks right out and ignores him. Look at the Boogie Woogie Man go now on Jeff Swords.
Right. John, notice Jimmy Vance.
His hand taped up. Also, maybe someone else is getting primed for you, assassin.
That's right. Vant has accepted the challenge of the assassin, so it's got to happen. He said
he's
taking out assassin
tape.
Number two, and it's got to end.
Got that mask off, assassin.
That's
number
right.
two.
It's got to end. One way or the other.
Well, I'm afraid with them fists taped up in a taped fist match, it just might end.
But the assassin's never lost one. Plus, John, he's got Paul Jones on his side.
Now, look.
But man, he can get down, he can get dirty.
The boogie-woogie man, like a lot of us, has had to put up with managers all through the wrestling career. He knows the ins and outs of that.
Look at that fist. He's showing the people. He's got a tape.
We mentioned a little of Wahoo McDaniels. I think the Boogie Woogie Man had a real good tab for him when the things that Wahoo has done. So Wahoo no more, Squahoo.
Oh, right into that corner. Hard fist in the midsection. Hank. And that was after that shoulder. Applying the pressure. Putting the blood supply off.
He's in that nerve area of the neck of Jeff Swords. You got to do something to paralyze those arms as big as they are on Jeff Swords.
That's correct. All right, Vant. But, all right, now when you watch this match, think about the assassin. Think about how Jimmy Vant's going to counteract the assassin. You saw him early in the program. You saw the assassin. How he takes his time, pounds away on his opponent. Vant, a ball of fire. How can he... in the ropes.
Just like that, David. We know that a tape fist match, you got to be a fighter. There's never been a street fighter like the Boogie Woogie Man. He grew up in the streets of New York City.
That's
how he survived.
I know. But this is a tape fist match. This has got to be different, John. I'm just wondering, we all love Jimmy Vant. He's one of the greatest guys around. But can he overcome two men? Paul Jones.
It's going to be a grueling test, and he's been through a lot of tests, but this is going to be a grueling test for Jimmy Vant, but he has to take that challenge. The things that's happened in the past, look at his beard. He used to have a long, blonde beard. He lost that to the assassin. The hands of the assassins are what cut his beard.
There you see that fist. He's holding that fist up. He's yelling for Paul Jones and the assassin. He has accepted the challenge.
The Jones and the assassin, when the words came out with that challenge a week ago, seemed awfully confident in that camp.
Yes.
The assassin, I never seen him more intense as he delivered the message towards Valiant.
Takes him, whips him across, into that turnbuckle. Ray catches him again in the midsection.
And that double over just towards it. And that big Oak Creek legs of his been on that one. And down he went. Here's a boogie woogie man rocks Swords again. Swords a powerful man, well over 300 pounds. Very hard to handle, but the boogie woogie man has found the area.
DC Van. Determination on his face. Waving that fist.
And that's for the assassin.
Backs him into the ropes. Comes across.
Sleeper hold! Off the rope! Went right into the sleeper hold! Valiant's got it locked up in the middle of the ring! Swords an awful long way from the ropes to get any kind of aid or relief. And I think we got a winner right here. Grand Prix. Tommy Young calls for it. A Boogie Woogie Man with a sleeper hold, David. Put him away.
That is correct. The Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vant. Watch out, assassin. Casey Vant backs into that rope.
This one cuts to right field.
And connects right ahead. And down he goes. Your winner, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vant.
This is WTVR TV6 Community Calendar. A Richmond Area Association for Retarded Citizens family picnic will be held on Saturday, August 18th from 2 p.m. until dark at Camp Baker, 7600 Beach Road in Chesterfield County. Bring swimsuits and plan for a good time. Call 748-4789 for reservations. If you ride a motorcycle, come join the fight against the crippling disease of arthritis at the 3rd Annual Arthritis Charity Poker Run. Come to Honda World, 6221 Hull Street Road at 10 a.m. on Sunday, August 19th. Call 282-5491 today for details. And the George Wythe High School class of 1964 is planning a 20-year class reunion, and they're trying to locate all 279 members of the senior class. If you have any information, please call 790-1117 after 6 p.m. Please send all information at least 3 weeks in advance to WTVR TV6 Community Calendar, 3301 West Broad Street, Richmond, Virginia.
It's the season when lovers everywhere are turning their thoughts to romance.
We even held hands as we walked along the sludge and the mud of the river.
Ah, the joy.
It just gets me all excited.
Oh, the rapture.
Yeah, I was just out of my skin about it.
As Love Connection brings singles together.
It was definitely a physical attraction.
Spring fever's highly contagious.
Here comes the romantic part.
Every day on Love Connection.
Love Connection, weekdays at 5 on TV6. This Sunday on the Alfred Hitchcock Hour.
Oh, Molly. Molly. Oh, I'm sorry, Molly. I'm sorry. I thought you were...
The Alfred Hitchcock Hour, Sunday nights at 11:30, here on TV6.
Nikita, who is preparing for action in this match, he's up against Gary Royal, a man that doesn't mind bending the rules a little himself, and he might find the going gets tough before this one's over.
The conceit in that man, Nikita Koloff.
All right. Come on, Royal.
Nikita Koloff is one of the six-man world tag team champions.
Good move on Royal's part. All right, see what it is. Nikita wants to tie up with him. Royal's a smart wrestler.
Very intelligent individual. Yes. We'll stay away from this streak.
Just rushing. There you see the pride. Don Canole. Hey, listen. Yes!
There you see Ivan Koloff. Don Canole on the outside. They're cheering on Nikita. Training of professional ranks for Nikita has come from those two men right there, Ivan Koloff and Don Canole.
Don't give up, guys. Don't give up, because we're going to beat those Russians.
And he's got tremendous strength and tremendous conditioning in the Russian athletes, as we've found time and time again when we've met them in the Olympics. And Nikita's no exception. He's very strong.
Look at him.
Display their fight.
He's got it, John. He's got it.
And Lara takes a
sometimes these people dislike Jerry Royal, but he's an American, and he's against the
They know what he's fighting for right now. Every patriotic fan in here, and they're on Royal's side tonight. But he's caught in that vice grip-like clamp of Nikita Koloff. Tremendous power. Look at the physique of him, David. Not a ounce of fat anywhere. Great condition.
Right, Nikita just squeezing with all his...
just drops him down like you would a sack of potatoes.
But Royal not giving up.
Oh,
the
no,
man's coming back to his feet.
He's a scrapper. Side suplex, and that's a well-executed maneuver right there.
Look at him strut.
Look at Canoodle and Cole off the outside.
But John, the conceit of the man just struts around the ring.
Looks like a Cobra clutch
here. It is a Cobra clutch.
Nikita Koloff coming with something new every time we see her. Cobra clutch on Gary Royal. Nikita's a tall man. Royal's, and we could have a winner right here.
He squeezed it, squeezed it.
Royal is out. Royal is out for that Cobra clutch. He finally breaks in the winner of the match. Nikita Koloff, there you see him. They toss Gary Royal high across the ring over and the match goes on to take the victory with a Cobra clutch. Nikita Koloff.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, those men I'm not proud of, but there's a young man right now you're going to see that I know we all are proud of. The World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. Let's see him right now because he's got an important announcement.
All around, water tanks around, waiting for rain. Thousand miles away from home. Ain't not a penny. Get
out. I called you on the phone. You told me to come down to your place. I drove up there, and I've been driving for 3 hours since to find you. I asked for a few minutes of your time. I know you got a bad gut reaction, but let's hear this out. Just a minute, Rick. This is my people here. It's my family here with me. You're posing on our hog hunting time. You're the only man dressed like you dress that's ever come down that road. Hey, Jack, you know you can find me, Sheriff, for any occasion you want. You want me to get rid of these clothes? Brother, tell me how you want it. How you want a few minutes of your time? Clothes got nothing to do with it. You know that, brother. I'm with it, and I'll go with it all the way. And I'll tell you what, Rick, a lot of stuff has come down between us over the years. A lot of things have happened to us. You own our property down here. You own the family's property. I knew you was coming. I wasn't for sure what you wanted and what is it you need. You're going to find this hard to believe. And I know you're going to say there's been a lot of bad blood between us. But I'm looking back to a few years ago. And you could depend on me and I could depend on you. I'm having problems in Charlotte. You know, I'm the world champion. Put that aside right now. I travel all over the world, and I compete against everybody there is. But the Mid-Atlantic area is my home, it's my baby. And I take a lot of pride in what happens there. I'm having problems right now with Walter McDaniels and Kelly Blanchard. Rick, just stop this for a minute. Let me tell you something. You and I, we've been down the road a long time together. And all these people around here understand me. And you always like the city lights. You always like the finer things of life. You always like Mercedes, Cadillacs, good-looking women. I always like kind of heavy-set women. The simpler things of life are important to me. How can you tell me and come to me now and need me? What do you need from me? Well, I'm going to tell you what I'm talking about. Regardless of the difference in our lifestyle, I remember one night when you pulled three guys off me at the treehouse in Charlotte. That's what I'm talking about. I need someone to stand at that backside right there. I'm having problems, and I want someone that I can depend on, a
at that back door. I'm telling you right now, the situation between Walter McDaniels and myself and Tully Blanchard, they got it.
Now, wait just a minute, Rick. But since I was a little boy, I've known Walter McDaniels.
I realize that.
He's been one of the greatest Indian athletes of all time. He's ranked up there with Jim Thorpe and some of the greatest athletes, one of the greatest football players. Now, you're telling me that you're having problems with Wahoo McDaniels?
I'm taking nothing away from Wahoo McDaniels' athletic credibility whatsoever. But the man has forgotten what friendship and what sportsmanlike conduct and the greatest sport in the world, a sport that's been both good for you and I both, is all about. And I could sit here all night long and tell you about Walter McDaniels. I'm asking you to dig back into a couple of years ago when we ran things in the Mid-Atlantic area and we ran things in the wrestling world. I want you to come back to Charlotte, come back to the Mid-Atlantic area. You haven't been home for a long time. This might be your home. This might be your new family. But you know, and I think they're honest with me, there's nothing wrong. Nothing wrong.
Hey, Rick, I'm going to tell you something. What you asked me to do is to go against somebody that I cared for. And you know how I love Charlotte. You know how I love the Carolinas. And we had a love affair between each other. I got to say this right now. It's something I got to sit on. It's something I got to think about for a little bit. And Wahoo McDaniels, and I know what's coming down. And Tully Blanchard, I'm going to sit on it a while and talk to my family. And I want you to sit with them. I want you to have a beer with them.
Give him a beer.
Have a beer, Rick. Sit down. Sit with my family for a while here.
Scott, won't you crack up one of them?
Put some music on here, boys.
Yeah, all right.
Hey, what's
the snake? Oh, man, the biggest rattlesnake I ever seen, man.
Hey, lad. Go ahead, sit down. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Sing one
for me. All the snakes crawl at night. That's what they say. All the snakes crawl at night. That's what they say.
You know damn well we have some of the greatest times in the history of professional wrestling in the Carolinas.
Kept what about all around the water tank?
All around the water tank.
Call you on the phone and talk your way out of pocket. Right.
What has got into Walter McDaniels?
I don't know what's got into Walter McDaniels.
Sleeping in the rain. And my pocketbook is empty.
When he brings in a creek.
Not a penny can I show.
Nothing happening. Creek.
Off, get off.
Tully Blanchard.
Rope on and slam the box.
You know Walter McDaniels has slipped. I'm talking about Virginia Beach and Myrtle Beach. I'm talking about the 2001 Whispers. I'm talking about the Mid-Atlantic area.
Sarah Jo still around?
She's still around, brother. A few pounds heavier, but she's still around.
That's all right. Yeah.
He likes them a few pounds.
Let's take time out for these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming up in your area. Friday, August 24th at 8:15, a big card, Hampton Roads Coliseum. You'll want to be on hand. Stafford Senior High School Gym in Fredericksburg, Virginia, big card on Thursday, August 23rd at 8:15. But now let's talk about a super spectacular card coming to the Richmond Coliseum on Friday, August 17th at 8:15. On the card, the World's Tag Team Champions Don Kernodle and Ivan Koloff go up against Brian Adidas and the Renegade. You'll see the Assassin number one with Paul Jones take on Rufus R. Freight Train Jones. For the TV title, a 20-minute time limit and $10,000. Pinfalls will count anywhere in the building as Tully Blanchard defends against Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vine. And then for the World's Heavyweight title, Ric Flair will defend his title against Chief Wahoo McDaniel. Let's bring in, first of all, the Renegade and Brian Adidas going up against the World's Tag Team Champions.
That's right. You know, Don Knudel, Ivan Koloff, I've seen you go round and round with the Renegade and Mark Youngblood. Now I have my chance with a partner right here as a Renegade. And anytime the World Tag Team belts are on the line, you can almost bet I'm going to be giving 110%.
Brian, as far as I'm concerned, brother, you always give 110%. Richmond, the last time we were there, it was 1, 2, 3, two falls. We beat you guys. And if the belts were up, we would have been World Tag Team Champions.
Bringing Rufus R. Freight Train Jones going up against the Assassin number one.
You know, the Assassin number one, every time you wrestle him, he come in the ring with his fist take up. I don't know the reason for that, but Assassin number one, brother, if I have to, I may go outside the ring and get me a chair to stop you. Cause Rufus Jones gonna put a stop to you one way or the other. You and that no good Paul Jones.
The heavyweight champion of the world, Ric Flair, defends his title against Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
You gotta know I'm looking forward to this. Richmond, woo! One of the finest wrestling cities in the entire world. And you know, I'm looking forward to walking to that Coliseum because all we've heard about is Wahoo McDaniel's being so bad. Yeah, you're bad when you got that slimy little punk with you. Two against one, you're real tough. Now, Wahoo, it's you and I. Head up the Richmond Coliseum. And those people in Richmond know a good fight, and they like a good fight, and brother, they're going to be there to see one hell of a fight. Because, Wahoo, I'm not backing down. We know you're not backing down. That means the best man walks out. Well, gear up, Wahoo, because I'm going to be ready to fight all night long. Woo!
You know, we could be watching the Richmond Braves play in a brand new stadium next season if we all pitch in to help. You can do your part by buying ballpark specials at participating stores, purchasing an I'm Pitching In button or t-shirt at Parker Field, or by making a contribution to the Metropolitan Foundation, 201 East Franklin Street in Richmond, 23219. Let's all pitch in to make sure next year's first pitch is thrown in a new ballpark, because unfortunately, diamonds aren't forever.
The shortest distance between you and an understanding of the news is a straight line of information. Direct, clear, reliable. Put together by an organization of seasoned journalists and presented by the nation's leading anchorman. As managing editor, Dan Rather knows how to report a story in the clearest possible way. That's why now, more than ever, the CBS Evening News with Dan Rather is the leading evening news broadcast in America.
All right, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Taking care of business right here. We're going to see what opportunity we have to see Tully Blanchard and Wahoo McDaniels together as a team, whether they're worthy of this. But I'm going to tell you something. Pistol Pez Wadley and Brian Adidas, I know this is going to be Upset City. This is going to be a great one. And the Dream going to stay right here and book it down on it.
All right, let's go to the ring right now and see Pistol Pez. Here you see that $10,000 and the NWA Television Championship held by Tully Blanchard. You'd like to have that for 60 minutes.
I see that 10 grand now. You see my eyes light up. I'm rolling in the back of my head because my taking care of business tool is after the $10,000.
All right. What about Ric Flair and Blackjack Mulligan, the Pack? They were. They, I tell you what, they're awesome.
I mean, this match is awesome here, but I was there on that hog hunt, and I was there with the family. And big Black Jack Mulligan and Ric Flair, as Ric Flair says, woo, it's going to be hot if it ever happens.
That is right. There you see. This is one of the first times Wahoo McDaniels and Tully Blanchard have teamed up together. Before, they've been denying it, but hey, they can't deny it now. Wahoo has turned. He has changed. He's a different man.
David, like I said before, he's a one-eyed jack. You see right there, pull the hair. He done found that he thinks that's the easiest way. After all these years of the great athletic ability he has, he found this the easiest way. But Brian Adidas gonna fire on him here, baby, because the kid has got a lot of fire, a lot of potential. And I'm gonna take him along with my taking care of business tool with me.
That he does. Brian Adidas, all right, has a headlock on Wahoo. All right, he needs to take Wahoo down on the mat and hold him, because Wahoo's got too much experience. If he stands up, he's got that chop.
You're right, David. One thing is, though, what he needs to do, if he's going to concentrate on the man's head, his noggin arm, whatever it is, they need to break him down a part at a time. There we go. See, right back to the head. Break the head down, and then the stomach going to fall. Break the stomach down, then the legs going to fall. That's what it's all about. Professional wrestling, greatest sport in the world. And Mark Penn. Tully Blanchard ran for 20 minutes against Dusty Rhodes and American Dream. Ran for 20 minutes. Now then, that's why I'm saying 60 minutes is going to cut out all this in between time.
All right, now, there you see Wahoo holding that hand back for the tag. All
Ooh, what a team. What a team Wahoo and Tully Blanchard are.
Hey.
Blackjack Mulligan and Ric Flair are something, but Tully Blanchard and Wahoo, they're something else.
Team for very long, and that was just a little bit of the confusion, and you see Pistol Pez dealt the upper hand right there.
You know, I noticed something, Dusty, that Tully Blanchard moves better backwards than he does forwards, because he's always backing up.
That's the fact. We ought to put his toes on his heels and see what he can do. There you go, Brian. Come on, baby. Right there, you see the vicious. I'm telling you now, you can't take it away.
Brian comes right in. Trying to take him down on that mat. Brian still holds on that arm. Tully takes him down again. Brian comes right back up. Tully takes him down. Brian's up again. Pulls him down. This young man, he's not giving up. Down.
He's got it up. There you go.
There he goes. Put that card over. And you see Tully Blanchard standing outside. All right. He's trying to dictate the pace of the match, the control.
See that wall we got? A Tully Blanchard. I'm going to call this from now on a Tully Blanchard lull in the program. Is the fact is he cannot do that. See, he tagged Wall with McDaniel standing on the floor. I'd like to congratulate Jim Crockett Promotions for bringing Barry Windham under the banner of Crockett Promotions. Tremendous athlete that he is. Could be a next world heavyweight champion.
That is true. That young man, he is something. And is going to be even better. All right, now they're in that ring. Tully backing up again. Brian Pace, all right, knocking the wind out of him. Tully takes him. Ramsey, over. All right, there goes Wahoo. There goes Wahoo. Wahoo rams his head right on the railing. Pez comes out. Brian trying to make it. Wahoo catches him. Time. Ah, there's that chop of Wahoo's. Oh, he can take your head off. Chops him again under the ropes. And again, he has him in the ropes. Pounds away. All right. Brian fighting back. Makes the tag.
All right, come on, baby. Super Bowl time.
Wrestling is a presentation of the JCP Sports Network and has been furnished to the station for broadcast at this time in exchange for commercial consideration.
Dusty! Hey, Dusty!